Hello, welcome to episode 13 of Bioshock. Today we're going to scavenging for some parts to build a water effector, which we got the instructions for in episode 12. If you haven't seen episode 12, there's a link in the description down below. If you haven't seen any of the previous episodes, I do recommend you go and watch them so you know where we're at, where we're up to. So, let's set up things around the video then.
The app would ride on my hip. So I get to thinking, we're paying for oxygen when we got photosynthesizing trees. Hell, we can even sell the extra to the rest of the city and undercut the other guys. Ryan would like that for sure. Fontaine's people have moved into the O2 biz tooth and claw.
So, I'm gonna upgrade the immunity to the great loss damage. That means I can fire grenades at the big daddies without taking any damage from it myself. So, I think that's it.
Welcome to the circus of value!
very long ago. To be a Boris. Boris. Took me to my heart strings. Even though this is built into Arcadia, it's still classed as a separate level. So there are more Big Daddy fights, and just one.
Shotgun. As to your question, yes, my days in beekeeping school are a blur, but I do seem to remember something about that enzyme you keep blabbing on about.
I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is.
Thank you.
such Frankenstein fathers, but we've all placed our hand on the great chain of endeavor. My hand is on it. Fontaine's is on it. We all pull it and are pulled by it. Yes, these children are an abomination. But it is not my hand alone on the chain that created them. No. Their little fingers were right there, next to mine.
You saved me. stands, a man most of standards. The pathetic prodigy done at Morley Winery has started putting water to his terrible wine. Water! When I confront him with this fatty, he tells me, Pierre, this is not to worry. The water, she is distilled. It could be worse. I could take it right from the ocean.
The children, with their very long needles, their tuneless songs, their ghastly errands, their ghoulish Frankenstein powers. But we've all placed our hand on the great chain of endeavor. My hand is on it. Fontaine's is on it. We all pull it and are pulled by it. Yes, these children are an abomination. But it is not my hand alone on the chain that created them. No. Their little fingers were right there, next to mine. First encounter with a pair of them. He, a lumbering palooka in a foul-smelling diving suit, and she, an unwashed moppet in a filthy pink smock. Her pallor was off, green and morbid. There was a rather unpleasant aspect to her demeanor, as if she were in an altogether different place than the rest of us. I understand the need for such creatures. Just wish they could make them more presentable.
One of the children came and sat in my lap. I push her off. I shout, get away from me. I can see the atom oozing out of the corner of her mouth. It's thick and green. Her filthy hair hanging in her face. Dirty clothes.
Useful for the next time I do after. I'll call the episode there. In the next episode, we'll head into the Whirly Wagon and continue looking for the Silver Nature and also get us the parts that we need to build the Lazarus Spectre. So, I'll thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and if you have, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Please do share the channel amongst your friends, just so I can build myself a wider audience. And thank you all for the support.